And just to let everybody know, we're going to switch the bold and the non-bold, so I start, I'm singing the bold, and everyone else is coming in on the non-bold. Sing praise to the Lord, all you faithful. Give thanks in holy remembrance.
God's wrath is short, God's favor lasts a lifetime. Weeping spends the night, but the joy comes in the morning.
While I felt secure, I said, I shall never be disturbed.
You, Lord, with your favor, make me as strong as the mountains. Then you hid your face, and I was filled with fear.
Hear, O Lord, and have mercy upon me. O Lord, be my helper.
You have turned my wailing into dancing. You have put off my sackcloth and clothed me with joy.
Therefore my heart sings to you without ceasing. O Lord my God, I will give you thanks forever.
Paul encourages the Corinthians to honor their commitment to participate in the collection his churches are organizing for the Christians in Jerusalem. He presents Jesus as an example of selfless stewardship and reminds them that Christians have received abundantly so that they can share abundantly. A reading from 2 Corinthians, the 8th chapter. Now, as you excel in everything, in faith, in speech, in knowledge, in utmost eagerness, and in love for you, so we want you to excel also in this generous undertaking. I do not say this as a command, but I am testing the genuineness of your love against the earnestness of others. For you know the generous act of our Lord Jesus Christ, that though he was rich, yet for your sakes he became poor, so that by his poverty you might become rich. And in this manner I am giving my advice. It is appropriate for you who began last year not only to do something, but even to desire to do something. Now finish doing it, so that your eagerness may be matched by completing it according to your means. For if the eagerness is there, the gift is acceptable according to what one has, not according to what one does not have. I do not mean that there should be relief for others and pressure on you, but it is a question of a fair balance between your present abundance and their need, so that their abundance may be for your need, in order that there may be a fair balance. As it is written, the one who had much did not have too much, and the one who had little did not have too little. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please stand.
She had endured much under many physicians and had spent all that she had,
She had heard about Jesus and came up behind him in the crowd and touched his cloak. For she said, if I but touch his clothes, I will be made well. Immediately, her hemorrhages stopped. And she felt in her body that she was healed of her disease. Immediately, aware that power had gone forth from him, Jesus turned about in the crowd and said, who touched my clothes? And his disciples said to him, you see the crowd pressing in on you. How can you say who touched me? Looked all around to see who had done it. But the woman, knowing what had happened to her, came in fear and trembling, fell down before him and told him the whole truth. He said to her, daughter, your faith has made you well. Go in peace and be healed of your disease. While he was still speaking, some people came from the leader's house to say, your daughter is dead. Why trouble the teacher any further? But overhearing what they said, Jesus said to the leader of the synagogue, do not fear, only believe. He allowed no one to follow him except Peter, James, and John, the brother of James. They came to the house of the leader of the synagogue. He saw a commotion, people weeping and wailing loudly. When he had entered, he said to them, why do you make a commotion and weep? The child is not dead, but sleeping. They laughed at him. Then he put them all outside. And he took the child's father and mother and those who were with him and went in where the child was. He took her by the hand and said, Tali kum, which means little girl, get up. And immediately the girl got up and began to walk about. She was 12 years of age. At this, they were overcome with amazement. He strictly ordered them that no one should know this. He told them to give her something to eat. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.